Hello there, survivors! Welcome back to another video on Scorched Earth in ARK Survival Ascended. Today, I'm showing you how to build a nice little base on top of the Oasisaur, but of course, you can also use this structure anywhere else as a nice little starter house. Now, I will be using some of the skins from the Frontier pack, and I will be building the structure out of adobe, but of course you can easily change around some of the materials, build it out of wood, build it out of stone if you don't have access to the Frontier pack, or if you just prefer a different look. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to subscribe and like the video, and if you want to show even more support, you can always become a YouTube member. Let's get to building. Okay, to get started, of course we're gonna have to place down a couple of foundations, so I'm gonna start out right here by placing them down like so. I'm gonna go for a 2x4 in total, so not a too big house, but I figure you don't have that much space here, so you don't want to go too big right away. You probably want to figure out where you want your door. I'm gonna go for right over here, and then we're gonna have these as windows over here and these as windows over there. This doesn't work in official, at least what I'm planning on doing with the inside of these, so you could also just use regular windows. And then I think here in the middle, I want to have two windows as well. And let's add another window right next to the door. For the other walls, we're just going to use the normal ones to close in and finish off the rest of this shape. So we should end up with a shape going on like this. Now right here in the front, I think we'll add a little porch in so that we do have a little bit of a front porch going on and we can enjoy a little lake. We're also gonna add some supports down here just to make it look a little bit better, and I think we're gonna do the same for our building. So we're gonna support the corners so that it all has a little bit more detail, and then I think we also want to have a beam going across except for where the door is. So I'm just gonna go around and I'm just gonna place these beams everywhere except for here, but we're gonna use as the door, but the rest of them can all have it. And then we're gonna actually add on a second little layer here on top of the wall just to make this a little bit higher, and of course we'll extend the pillars in the corners as well. So then we'll take out those sloped walls to end off this shape as well, make it all look a little bit nicer. Okay, and then we actually need a couple of extra snap points, so we're gonna add these quarter ceilings right there in the corner of the building so that if we take out our ramps. Okay, then we're gonna have to cycle through the snap points until we get the right one. I find it is the easiest if you stand on top of the quarter ceiling, because I mean the Oasisaur of course moves around quite a bit. And then you actually want to find the second snap point here as well. We're gonna overlap these structures here in the corner, then we can extend this. Unfortunately, this will just get us all the way to the other side. Then we want to get the right snap point here again so that we have the overlap like so. Then we can go on, continue like this. We do the same here on the other side, so we'll continue the ramps here along the outside. Then we need to get the right snap point again, so again I would suggest standing on top of it until you find the right one. And then you can just continue them along the edge and connect them, and it should all line up. So this is what it should end up looking like. Unfortunately, we still don't have any corner pieces for ramps, so we have this little overlap going on. That's also the main reason why this design isn't possible in official, unfortunately. We're gonna extend the roof with the normal roof tile right there, and then we're gonna do this same on the other side here as well. Now, of course, you can pick different materials if you like the look more. Normally, I really like using stone because the textures stay the same between the ramps and the roof parts. But of course, feel free to change them around. I probably will change these to look like the Frontier skins ones. Okay, then on top of the roof, we're actually gonna add a sloped wall like so on both ends of the roof just to give that extra shape to it. And this is where you want to add in some extra fences along the top of the roof, just to add in some more details. And I kind of like the way this makes it all look. Again, You are completely free to use any kind of material that you like. I just wanted to go for the Adobe because of the extra bonus effects here on Scorched Earth. But of course, feel free to do anything. I've done most of my other builds in this style with mostly stone on the roof. So we're actually going to place down a little more pillars. We're going to have pillars here around the windows just because we'll use them in a little bit to add in some nicer shapes. And if you want some taller windows, since the building is quite tall, we can even add in some windows above where we have them right now. So you could extend them like this if you want some taller windows instead of the walls that we have before. But of course, that's completely up to your own preference. And then we also want to add in some extra railings at the end here of the ramps. A little bit hard to see because of the tree right in front of my house here. But yeah, just as an extra little detail, we want to add them onto the end of all these ramps. Because I just like the look of having it stick out even further. And these just extended that little bit more. Now we can actually also do these windows by finding the right snap point here in the middle and snapping your railing in like so, right there. And if you have one of them, you can just mirror it to the other side, and then you can just add some extras above them. And this makes for quite an interesting window design, I would say. Quite airy as well. And if you wish, you can also add normal railings down below to kind of finish off this shape. The alternative, of course, if you don't want to be adding in all these little railings, is that you can just use the normal full walls and use the frontier skin to make some big windows instead. If you have the frontier skin, that's a really nice way to make windows now, of course. So just have it like this and we'll make some big windows wherever we want to add them, because they do look very nice and it's just a nice easy way to add in some big windows to enjoy your view, which from the top of an Oasisaur, you probably do want to enjoy your view. Then right here on the front of your porch, you probably want to add in either some stairs or some ramps. In my case, because how far away I placed it, I'm going to use some ramps because that makes it fit right into the little pool, which you can use to get some buffs, of course. And if you want to add some support along your porch, the easiest way is to snap them from the ramps, because of course, this doesn't quite line up. So you just find these snap points, and I would go for some thin pillars along the bottom to add in these supports. These are probably enough. And then to add some extra details, we can add in some railings along your porch to keep it all safe when you're enjoying the view and enjoying your front porch. Now that is pretty much the entire design done. Of course, I'm going to be changing it to the frontier skin in a little bit because I like the look of that. I would also suggest highly painting at least the roof. I like the marine color for that a lot. Now, if you want, you can't actually place any more foundations in the back of this. Well, maybe depending on where you are, you can. But we could still add in another little porch here on the back if you want some more room. Maybe if you want to have some more crafting around, you can actually make a little back porch as well, just to give yourself a little bit more space. I would again have some supports going down from the ramps just to make it all look a little bit better supported. And then maybe you could even add in some supports for the platform itself as well, for your little porch extension, just to make it look a little bit stronger and a little bit more supported. Then, of course, I'd always add some railings around, especially here on the back, because we're quite close to the edge of the Oasisaur. And if you do add this, you, of course, want to add in an extra door and take away the beam you have at the bottom of that. And this gives you a little bit more space to place maybe down some extra crafting stations or storage. And it gives you a nice spot to look out and enjoy the view. Of course, we want to be adding in our doors as well, both on the back and front, so that we can close off our little house. And that is pretty much it. So now all I'm going to do is update it to the right skins, because I do like the look of this a lot. And I think even for this style, it fits quite well. But again, as I said at the beginning, you are completely free to choose whatever materials you want to use, because it should look good with most. And of course, this is also a build you could easily just do somewhere else, It doesn't actually have to be on the back of an Oasisaur. Now, if you're using the Frontier skins, you actually want to change these to the glass skin because you get the little window in there as well, which actually is one of my favorite textures because it adds so much detail that you can't really do with any other structures that we have available. It's kind of like cheating. And there we go. By changing the looks, it would look something like this. I already like that a lot more. I really love the look of this, especially the little window on these sloped walls. But of course, if you do not have the Frontier pack, you can still use any other materials. I'd probably suggest the stone roof at least, just because those textures line up very nicely as well. But in this case, you can see even with different textures, you can still make it look pretty nice. Now that's actually it for the little starter house. I think it's nice and cozy, and it's nice to have a different style house than the normal Frontier houses or the adobe structures that you usually see people build here on Scorched Earth. What you can do is add in another little gazebo somewhere. So we want to find somewhere where we can place down a pillar like so. And then we can actually have our triangle ceilings and connect them in a circle like this, which will give us a nice little gazebo. Then to actually make it supported, I probably either with thin pillars or with thicker pillars would add in some proper supports, because otherwise it does look like it's just floating, of course. So you do want to make sure that you have some support around the whole place. Probably also want to make sure that you have a way to actually get up to your little gazebo, so place some stairs down as well. You can have some railings alongside your stair, and then we have the little shape will turn into the gazebo itself. I'd use thin pillars for this just because I think it looks a little bit nicer. So we'll go all the way around. We'll also add in some extra railing so you can't fall off. There we go. So it should be looking something like this. Now then we actually want to place down these roof pieces like so, the triangle roof pieces, to make this little shape, which turns it into a nice little gazebo. It's really simple, but it's very effective, and it adds another little nice place here on your Oasisaur just to hang out, relax, maybe place down some extra stuff that you need. Could be a perfect place for like a small teleporter platform if you want to use those. Yeah, it's just a nice little addition. And again, in my case, I would switch this to the Frontier skins just because I really like those textures, and just to match up with the other build that we've already done on top of the Oasisaur to make it all fit together a little bit nicer. So then you would end up with something looking like this, and that together makes for a really nice little base. So there we go. This is my little Oasisaur base. We've got this little gazebo here, which is purely aesthetic. Also because I didn't have any structures left on the limit. I've got the little windmill to protect a generator if I would want it, but I don't have it right now because I placed probably too many details in the interior. And we've got a little structure going on. So I've got some lamps everywhere, and we've got a little couch to look out over the world whilst we're traveling. And we've got a nice little table here to chill out. You could also replace it and place down a poker table, of course. A little bit of storage, a piano, then some more storage, the forges, the smithy, and just a nice place to hang out here on the back of the Oasisaur. Enjoy the view whilst you're traveling, or when you're just hanging out in the air like so. So again, it's quite a simple simple build, but I think you kind of have to with the limits that you have on the Oasisaur. So far as I know, I am not really extending the build limit on platforms on our server, but yeah, if it is, it might be doubled or something. But hopefully this should be able for everyone, because I can't remember changing anything. So you should be able to build at least this little house. Maybe we'll have to leave out a couple of details. I actually found out that I had no room for a bed anymore, so instead I put down a coffin outside. Yeah, that's maybe a little bit dark, but it works. And there we have it. That is it for this tutorial. Hopefully you enjoyed. If you did, don't forget to leave the like, subscribe, and hopefully I will see you in the next one. Goodbye.